We're given several terms in a sequence and asked to determine if the sequence is arithmetic, geometric, or neither. To review, if a sequence is arithmetic, that means to find consecutive terms, we would add a constant each time. Or more formally, consecutive terms in an arithmetic sequence have a common difference d, which is equal to a sub n minus a sub n minus 1, which means if the sequence is arithmetic and we select any term in the sequence, a sub n, and we subtract the previous term, a sub n minus 1, the common difference d will always be the same. A sequence is geometric if the pattern is that we multiply by a constant to find consecutive terms, or more formally, consecutive terms have a common ratio if the sequence is geometric. Which means if we select any term a sub n and divide by the previous term a sub n minus 1, the quotient must always equal a constant r. So if we analyze this first sequence, if we recognize that the terms are increasing by 5, since negative 11 plus 5 is equal to negative 6, negative 6 plus 5 is equal to negative 1, negative 1 plus 5 is equal to positive 4, 4 plus 5 is equal to positive 9, and so on, this is telling us that we have a common difference d, which is equal to 5, and therefore we have an arithmetic sequence. If we're not able to analyze the sequence to recognize that we're adding 5 each time, then we can go ahead and use the formula for d and r to test to see whether we have an arithmetic or geometric sequence. For example, using the formula for d, if we select the first two terms, we would have d equals the second term minus the first term, or negative 6 minus negative 11. This becomes negative 6 plus 11, which is equal to positive 5. This alone doesn't tell us the sequence is arithmetic, but notice once we found this, if we add 5 to negative 6, we do get negative 1. If we add 5 again, we do get positive 4, and so on. Or if we wanted to, we could select two other consecutive terms, let's say negative 1 and 4, and see if we get the same value for d. D would be equal to the second term minus the first term, or 4 minus negative 1, which becomes 4 plus 1, which is equal to positive 5. So now that we found d twice for two pairs of consecutive terms, this would be enough information to tell us the sequence is arithmetic. Let's go ahead and test r to make sure r is not the same. If we again use the first two terms, the common ratio r would be equal to the second term divided by the first term. Negative 6 divided by negative 11 is 6 elevenths. If we try to find r using the third and fourth term, we would have r equals 4 divided by negative 1. We can easily see these are not the same values, and therefore the sequence cannot be geometric. Now looking at our second example, sometimes when we have fractions in the sequence, it can be a little more challenging. The recommendation is to obtain common denominators in the fractions. Since 2 is the same as 2 over 1, notice our common denominator would be 4. So we could also write this as 2 over 1 is equal to 8 fourths. Then we have 9 fourths. And then for 5 halves, we'd multiply both the top and bottom by 2. 5 halves is equal to 10 fourths. Then we have 11 fourths, and so on. Well, in this form, if we can recognize that to go from 8 fourths to 9 fourths, we would add 1 fourth. And to go from 9 fourths to 10 fourths, we would add 1 fourth. This is how we're adding a constant each time, which means this will be an arithmetic sequence. 10 fourths plus 1 fourth is equal to 11 fourths. So again, if we recognize this right away, we know that d is equal to 1 fourth, and we have an arithmetic sequence. If we don't recognize this pattern, we have to use our formulas to see if we have a common d or a common r. Either way, it's still going to be helpful that we obtain a common denominator. So for example, let's go ahead and use the first two terms to determine d. D would be equal to the second term minus the first term. Well, 9 fourths minus 8 fourths. Since we have a common denominator, this is just 1 fourth. And if we use the second and third term, or these two terms here, again we'd have the third term minus the second term, which would be 10/4 minus 9/4. Notice how the difference is still 1/4, verifying we have a common difference for our sequence. If we try to find a common ratio using the first two terms, we'd have 9/4 divided by 8/4, which is the same as 9/4 times the reciprocal, which would be 4/8. The 4s simplify out. We have a ratio of 9/8. Now let's find the common ratio using the second and third terms. We'd have 10/4 divided by 9/4, or times the reciprocal, which will be 4/9. Notice how the 4s simplify out. So now we have a ratio of 10/9, which obviously doesn't equal 9/8, and therefore this cannot be a geometric sequence. Okay, I hope you found this example helpful. We'll take a look at two more examples in the next video.